I don't want to see her. I don't want to. Sandy, how wonderful to see you.
Donna!
You look wonderful.
Oh, gosh, this whole thing is nothing.
Well, that's what I mean, but it'll be great when it comes back in style.
Oh, same old Sandy. Come on, and I want you to meet my daughter, Evie.
Oh, wow. Hi, how's it going?
Hi. Wow, you are tall.
Yes, she is. How about you sit down?
Donna, I would have never believed that you would have such a beautiful daughter. Oh, your husband must be very handsome.
How tall are you?
Very tall. Sandy, please sit down.
What a lovely home. Oh, you must have a decorator.
Thanks. Sandy, sit.
Oh. So, Donna, tell me all about yourself.
Oh, well, there really isn't very much to tell.
Are you kidding? My mom is the mayor of Marlowe and the captain of her bowling team.
Wow. I heard that you married a guy from out of town.
Way out of town.
So, Sandy, tell us about you. I'm sure you married a rich, successful guy.
Oh, I sure did. George is in transportation.
Well, I can see that you don't have to work. What do you do with yourself all day?
Oh, anything I want. I spend a lot of time at Gucci's.
What did I tell you? Leave it to Sandy to be living the good life. Well, Sandy, thanks so much for stopping by. It's been great to see you. It's just a shame you don't have a few days to spend with us.
Oh, well, actually, I have a few days.
You do? Well, gee, it would be great if you could stay here, but I'm sure that you would prefer a fancy hotel.
Oh, no! Oh, I don't mind.
You don't?
No, are you sure it wouldn't be an imposition?
Of course not. Why do you think I've been twisting your arm?
Oh, Donna, this will be so much fun. We can catch up on old times.
Yes, don't do that. Gee, Sandy, you know, though, I have a city council meeting in 10 minutes, but I won't be very long. And in the meantime, Evie, my daughter here, will keep you company.
Oh, that'll be great. All right, well, I'll just go get my suitcase.
What happened to a quick chat and then boom, she's out of here?
I couldn't let her stay at a hotel. Heaven knows I tried.
Why stick around and keep her company? We won't have anything to talk about.
Oh, honey, I want you to try and make Sandy feel at home. Oh, Evie, sure, she's a snob and she's pushy and she's conceited. But she is one of my dearest friends. Welcome, Sandy. Oh, poor Evie. She must be bored to tears. Hi.
Oh, hi, Mom. Hi. Sandy and I are having so much fun. We had hot fudge sundaes, and we did our nails. Oh, and you know how you did my hair last week? Sandy was able to fix it.
Thanks, Sandy.
I don't know what I could do with yours. It's too bad I'm not staying longer.
Yeah.
Guess what I picked up on my way home? One of my favorite things.
Refills for your dustbuster?
No, no. A Hard Day's Night. Sandy and I were crazy about the Beatles. I thought it would be fun to watch it tonight.
Mom, do we have to? Sandy promised she'd help me color coordinate my wardrobe. She's such a great dresser. Mm-hmm.
I get most of my things at the Young and Sassy department.
I buy most of mine at the Barbara Bush boutique.
Besides, we want to catch Arsenio tonight. He's having the New Kids on the Block.
Oh, I didn't know we had any New Kids on the Block. When did they move in?
New Kids is a rock group.
Oh, right. Like they be 40.
Yeah. Well, Sandy knows all the rock groups and all the steps of the latest dances. She is so cool.
She is. She's very cool. Very cool. Well, I think I'll go in the kitchen now and brush up on my minuet.
I don't want to see her. I don't want to. Sandy! How wonderful to see you!
Donna!
You look wonderful.
Oh, gosh, this whole thing is nothing.
Well, that's what I mean, but it'll be great when it comes back in style.
Oh, hey, old Sandy. Come on, and I want you to meet my daughter, Evie.
Oh, wow. Hi, how's it going?
Hi. Wow, you are tall.
Yes, she is. How about you sit down?
Donna, I would have never believed that you would have such a beautiful daughter. Oh, your husband must be very handsome.
How tall are you?
Very tall. Sandy, please sit down.
What a lovely home. Oh, you must have it decorated.
Thanks, Sandy, sit.
Oh, so, Donna, tell me all about yourself.
Oh, well, there really isn't very much to tell.
Are you kidding? My mom is the mayor of Marlowe and the captain of her bowling team.
Wow. I heard that you married a guy from out of town.
Way out of town.
So, Sandy, tell us about you. I'm sure you married a rich, successful guy.
Oh, I sure did. George is in transportation.
Well, I can see that you don't have to work. What do you do with yourself all day?
Oh, anything I want. I spend a lot of time at Gucci's.
What did I tell you? Leave it to Sandy to be living the good life. Well, Sandy, thanks so much for stopping by. It's been great to see you. It's just a shame you don't have a few days to spend with us.
Oh, well, actually, I have a few days.
You do? Well, gee, it would be great if you could stay here, but I'm sure that you would prefer a fancy hotel.
Oh, no! Oh, I don't mind.
You don't?
No, are you sure it wouldn't be an imposition?
Of course not. Why do you think I've been twisting your arm?
Oh, Donna, this will be so much... Morning, Donna.
Morning, Sandy. Don't you look young and sassy?
Well, to dress young is to be young. That's what I say.
Well, what would you like for breakfast? Cereal? Toast? Pablum?
Morning.
Ah! Well, if it isn't the Doublemint twins.
Mom, isn't it great? Sandy and I have the exact same taste in clothes. Oh, but I wish you're as tall as she is.
Mm. Oh, well, don't worry, honey. You will be. After all, your father is 11 feet tall. Dad had Elvis's love child. I'm going to finish getting ready for work.
So, Evie? Evie, what's wrong?
Oh, nothing. It's just I had this math test today. We were up so late last night making friendship bracelets, I didn't have a chance to study.
Oh, well, that's no problem. You just ditched school.
I can't do that.
Oh, yeah, sure you can. I used to do it all the time.
You did?
Yeah, besides, why risk getting a bad grade on a test when teachers let you make up exams all the time?
You think so?
Uh-huh. And if you ditch school, we could go to the mall and we could go earring shopping.
Earring shopping? I love earrings. I'm practically an earringaholic.
Me too. Any size, any shape. So what do you say? Oh, come on. School's for fools.
And the mall's a ball.
All right.
Great. Evie?
So, I'll meet you at Pierce 2 for me in half an hour.
Okay. Honey, look at the time. You'll be late for school.
Oh, we don't want to do that. I'll run all the way.
Have a good day.
Okay, I will.
Bye.
Bye.
Well, Sandy, I'm really sorry I can't spend the day with you, but I've got a budget review over at City Hall.
Oh, that's okay, Donna. I'll think of something to amuse myself. Oh, I know. Maybe I'll work out a little.
I have to admit, your weight hasn't changed since high school.
Oh, well, sure it has. I lost 10 pounds.
Please come in.
Hi, Mrs. Garland. Is Evie home?
Oh, no, honey, you just missed her.
Oh, wow, you must be Sandy.
Hi.
Evie was right. You are so cool.
Isn't she, Mrs. Garland?
So I've been told.
I wish my mom had cool friends like you. All her friends are such dweebs.
Lindsay, I happen to be one of your mother's friends.
Oh, well, of course, except for you, Mrs. Dweeb. I mean, Mrs. Garland. Yeah, well, I gotta be going now.
Ow! Oh, Lindsay, watch where you're going, will you?
Oh, sorry, Chief Applegate.
You stepped on my big toe. I got a bad corn. It's really killing me. Ah! What's a little pain to a big, brawny guy such as myself? Madonna? Who's your incredibly lovely friend?
Kyle, this is Sandy Martin.
Hi.
How do you do, little lady? Kyle Licks Applegate here. A one-time star of television, movies, and a dental floss commercial.
Oh, you were an actor.
No, just a star. You probably remember me in The Sound of Music.
You were in The Sound of Music?
not music. Muzak. We've altered place in an elevator. Well, of course, now I'm chief of police of this fair city.
You're the chief of police? How exciting.
Yep. Yep. Why, I was out all morning patrolling our freeways and doing a darn fine job. Well, so far, not one freeway has been stolen.
I gotta run.
I would.
Wow, she is so cool.
Kyle, how would you like a Danish up your nose?
A little testy, aren't we?
Sorry. Just so tired of hearing how cool Sandy is. I think I'm jealous. Evie would rather be with Sandy than with me.
Oh, Donna. I'm sure you're just imagining. I'm sure nobody is choosing Sandy over you.
Really?
Oh, that's sweet of you to say, Kyle.
Why are you here?
Hmm? Oh, I almost forgot. I got two tickets to the Phantom of the Opera. I thought you might like to go with me.
Oh, wonderful!
Now that I met Sandy, I think I'll ask her. Ow!
Oh, I'm sorry.
Evie, that was so much fun. 8 hours of nonstop shopping.
It took a lot of willpower, but I didn't blow my money on earrings.
Way to go.
Instead, I blew it on the sweater.
Hi, honey. Hi, Sandy. Evie, you are home awfully late from school.
Oh, yeah, I was shop. I was in shop class.
You don't take shop.
Right. That's why I was late. I was in the wrong class.
What an airhead.
So what do you guys want to do tonight?
Oh, well, I promised Sandy we could go to the Goody Goody.
Yeah, I can't wait to see the old place.
Oh, well, that sounds like fun.
Remember when they had the contest at the Goody Goody for the most popular customer?
Did you win?
No.
See, Mom, Sandy didn't win everything.
I won for their prettiest customer. And they named a dessert after me.
The Hot Fudge Sandy.
And they gave away free candy bars in my honor.
Sandy bars.
Oh, and that was the night that Dennis Foley asked me to go steady with him.
You know, on second thought, I think I'll just stay home tonight.
But why?
I don't know. I'm just not in the mood for a Sandy burger.
You sure?
Well, we better hurry. We want to get a good table. Come on.
All right.
You know, there are no good tables at the Goody Goody.
See you later.
Bye.
That does it. If Evie wants a pal instead of a mom, that's what she's going to get. From now on, I'm going to dress young and think hip and be tall. Well, 2 out of 3 ain't bad.
You know what we used to do? We used to suck up ketchup in a straw and then we would blow it at the customers.
Sandy, don't! It's rained all over my new sweater. Sandy, it isn't funny.
Oh, really? Well, you should see yourself.
Oh,
Evie, chill out. But nobody will even notice it.
Oh, hi, guys. Oh, Evie, you know you got a big ugly blob of ketchup on your sweater? Hey, where were you today?
Oh, Evie and I played hooky and we went shopping all day.
How's the math test?
Oh, piece of cake. Even I passed.
I gotta ask for a makeup tomorrow. Oh, Mr. Marcus said he isn't giving any makeups. He said that anyone who missed the test today gets an automatic F.
An F? I've never gotten an F in my life.
Oh, well, it's not such a big deal. I got plenty of them.
Oh, hey, guys. Evie, did you know you got a big, ugly blob of ketchup on your sweater?
Yes, Chris, I'm aware of it.
Oh, Evie, this is Chris. Oh, well, you said he was cute, but you didn't say that he was drop-dead gorgeous. Oh, look, he's blushing.
I hate when that happens. It clashes with my tan.
He is adorable.
Excuse us. I can't believe it. She's flirting with Chris. How uncool. There's nothing more pathetic than a grown woman trying to act like a teenager.
Yo! I'm Big D Donna, and I'm on the scene. So fix me a burger and make it leap.
I just can't.
came back from the record store where I was jamming with Cherry Vanilli and Oinky Boinky.
Mom, that's Milli Vanilli and Oingo Boingo.
Whatever. And that Paula Abdul Jabbar, what a dancer.
Mom, why are you acting this way?
What? I'm being young and sassy like Sandy.
Why would you want to act like Sandy?
Because you're crazy about her, that's why.
I'm not crazy about her. Well, okay, maybe I was. I'm not anymore. Okay, I thought she was cool, but she's not. She's irresponsible, she's immature, she's totally self-centered.
And she's standing right behind you.
She's standing right behind me. Whoops. Sorry.
It's okay, Evie. And she's right, Donna. But there's a reason why I've been acting like such a jerk. I mean, the truth is that I've just made such a complete mess of my whole life.
What are you talking about? You're married to a big shot in transportation, and you spend all your time in Gucci's.
It's time I told you the truth. My husband was a bus driver. And I say was because about a month ago, he left me for a meter maid. And as far as Gucci's is concerned, well, I'm a receptionist for Gucci Brothers Plumbing. Hello, Gucci Brothers, where a flush beats a full house.
Sandy, why did you think you had to lie to me?
Envy. Now, I might have been a big deal in high school, but in real life, you've got it all. I mean, Donna, I walked into your lovely home, and then I met your beautiful daughter. And I got so jealous. I'm sorry.
Oh, Sandy.
Oh,
I'm sorry.
Well, I think it's time to go.
Where?
Out with my best friend.
Oh, on one condition.
What's that?
That I can bring along one of my best friends.
Oh, really?
Really.